riding high on championship success in 2021. There was much to be expected of Quartararo and Yamaha in the 2022 season. Joined full-time by Franco Morbidelli and the factory team and the rebranded With You RNF Yamaha team, running MotoGP multiple race winner Andrea Dovizioso and straight from Moto3 rookie Darren Binder. It has been a year of contrast, but as MotoGP enters its summer break, Quartararo leads the way, but as we will see, it's been anything other than plain sailing. 2022 kicked off under the floodlights in Qatar, and confidence was high in Yamaha after Quartararo and Vinales won for the Hamamatsu factory in 2021. However, Quartararo's title defence got off to a slow start as the reigning champion was passed on a run to the line by fellow Frenchman Johann Zarco. Finishing 9th and 10 seconds off the win, Yamaha's struggling start to the year was compounded by Morbidelli finishing 11th, while Dovizioso could only salvage 2 points in 14th. Things looked on the up as MotoGP made its way to Indonesia for round 2. The fast and flowing nature of the circuit suited the characteristics of the Yamaha. Quartararo took his first pole of the year, but rain fell on Sunday, throwing the form book out the window. Not known for his prowess in the wet, Quartararo produced a masterful ride on his way to second place. It was a double top 10 for the Monster Energy Yamaha as Morbidelli recovered from a 3-place grid penalty after a practice start infringement during practice. He charged from 14th on the grid to 7th. MotoGP rookie Darren Binder impressed on the 2021 Yamaha, taking to the wet track like a duck to water, and found himself in a fight for 8th with 6 other riders, which included brother Brad. He eventually came out in 10th at the flag and proving to a lot of people that he can ride with the very best in MotoGP. Termaster Rio Honda was next up for round 3 of the championship, and after promise of Indonesia, Yamaha found themselves with work to do once more. Not featuring inside the top 5 for much of the weekend, Quartararo was the only Yamaha to finish in the points after Morbidelli suffered a puncture and Andrea Dovizioso entered the pits on lap 1 as a result of his front right height device sticking on. Moving from South America to the north, the circuit of the Americas in Austin, Texas was next up. The stop and start nature of COTA played against the strength of the Yamaha and Quartararo. The reigning champ found himself in a late race scrap for 6th with Marc Marquez, eventually losing out to the 8-time champ. Things were beginning to look worrying, as Quartararo was the only Yamaha rider that could fight inside the top 10 on a regular basis, but even then, that was proving difficult. As the championship moved back to Europe and to Portimão in Portugal, here is where Quartararo's season got up and running. The champion looked back to his brilliant best. Starting 5th, Quartararo found himself in 2nd from the get-go, trading fastest laps with Joan Mir. The 2021 champ cruised past at the start of lap 4 and from then on set about opening up a gap over his rivals. Eventually taking the checkered flag over 5 seconds from his nearest rival, not only did he make a return to winning ways, but it also marked the start of a stunning run of form. Heading into round 6 of Jerez, there was a feeling that Quartararo could make it back-to-back wins, as he and Yamaha both worked well around the Andalusia circuit. Starting 2nd on the grid, he held position into turn 1, and despite putting pressure on Bagnaia for the win, he couldn't push the Italian into a mistake, eventually taking the checkered flag only 2/10 off the win, but in doing so, he took the outright championship lead by 7 points over Aleix Espargaró. While Quartararo was beginning to enjoy success, the same couldn't be said for Monster Energy Yamaha teammate Franco Morbidelli. The Italian having a disastrous start to the year, sitting down in 16th on 18 points after a 15th place finish, a year on from his last podium to date. On to Le Mans, and the first time Fabio Quartararo got to race in front of his home fans since becoming world champion. Expectations were high on the back of a win in second place, but a home win would be the absolute dream. But that's not how it played out. Starting 4th, Quartararo found himself pushed back on the opening lap, before eventually recovering to 4th place and importantly only losing 3 points to main championship rival Aleix Espargaró. The Tuscan Hills played host to the Italian GP at Mugello, where Quartararo and Yamaha both tasted success in 2021. But with a top speed disadvantage, it proved to be a real test. Starting 6th after a rain-affected qualifying, the reigning champ ran with the Ducatis in the early stages, finding himself on the receiving end of overtakes into Turn 1 at the end of the long straight. However, when he got into 2nd, he set his sights after race leader Bagnaia. Try as he might, he would never get close enough to launch an attack. But finishing 2nd and less than 1 second off the win was considered an enormous achievement in itself by many within the paddock, and finishing 20 seconds ahead of next Yamaha, Darren Binder, proving once more that Quartararo was working absolute wonders on the Yamaha. A circuit that both Yamaha and Quartararo have had success at in the past. The Catalan GP at the Circuit de Barcelona, Catalunya would prove to be as difficult as Mugello. Struggling in low grip conditions, in practice, the championship leader made the most of a front row start, launching into the lead into Turn 1, where he would never look back. Taking the win by over 6 seconds, it was a pure display of dominance that sent shockwaves to his rivals. The other Yamahas found some performance throughout the Catalan GP weekend, as Darren Binder scored his best drive result in MotoGP. Locked in a race-long battle with fellow rookie Remy Gardner, he would eventually cross the line in 12th and reaffirming his impressive start to his rookie campaign. Just behind the South African was Franco Morbidelli. Despite his low finishing position, he was confident improvements had been found after an encouraging Friday, but slipped back in qualifying, which led to a difficult race. Tight, twisty and filled with long sweeping corners, the Sachsenring on paper is a match made in heaven for Quartararo and Yamaha. With Marc Marquez out of action for the foreseeable future, this was Quartararo's chance to really steal a march on the championship, and that's precisely what he did. Sweeping into the lead at Turn 1 and briefly coming under attack from Bagnaia, no one could come close to his speed, seemingly reeling off 1 minute 21s with ease. Crossing the line almost 5 seconds ahead of Zarco, and in doing so opening up a 34 point gap in the standings as the championship reached its halfway stage. While Morbidelli found himself stuck near the back after another difficult qualifying, he recovered to 13th just ahead of Dovizioso on the RNF Yamaha. The final destination before the summer break. Assen, another favourite of Yamaha, but this weekend would be a blot on Quartararo's copybook. Finding himself running third in opening laps and behind main championship rival Aleix Espargaró, the reigning champion made a move on the Aprilia man at Steuben, which resulted in Quartararo losing the front and crashing out, dragging Espargaró into the gravel. Both rejoined, but Quartararo being out of contention came into the pits before being sent back out again in the hope that rain would eventually fall. But his race came to an end after a high side coming out of Steuben on lap 11. Leaving the world champion hobbling away into the summer break, and on top of this, was given a long lap penalty for Silverstone as a result of his crash on lap 5 with Aleix. Steuben turned out to be kryptonite for the Monster Energy Yamaha team, as Franco Morbidelli's race came to a premature end when he crashed after being given a double long lap penalty for failing to come in for a previous long lap penalty that he was given due to impeding Bastianini and Bezzecchi in FP2. Compounding a miserable season so far for Morbidelli and a disastrous day for Yamaha, as the only rider to finish was Dovizioso all the way down in 16th. Quartararo has been the leading light for Yamaha, arguably performing on an even higher level than he did in his title winning year. He has been able to find performance from the Yamaha which others can only dream of. 3 wins, 6 podiums in total, the most of anyone on the grid, and a 21 point gap at the top of the standings, there is no doubt that Quartararo is the man to beat. The question is, can anyone catch him? Despite the crash at Assen and on the basis of what we've learned so far, it'll be extremely difficult to stop Quartararo on his quest for a second MotoGP championship.
Hi, it's Fabio Quartararo. Hope you give us a like and subscribe.